some of our larger cities in the state, Mobile, Montgomery, Birmingham, we are 2 out of 21 of all those cities. So what I thought we would just kind of talk about is for different companies and things like that, planning an event, whether it's a birthday party, conference, convention, just to kind of give you some strategic tools about different things that you might do. The first thing is just kind of deciding what kind of event you're looking to plan. You can break this down into social, which is going to be like your weddings, reunions, things like that. Conferences, which is usually association, government type meetings, also fraternal. Local meetings, which kind of falls under corporate training, civic groups like Rotary or something like that. Sporting events, of course, things that are amateur leagues, professional leagues, or tournaments. Or concerts, entertainment type venues, and things like that. So that's kind of like the main breakdowns of different events. When you're deciding to plan an event, you need to pick a date. Things to kind of look to is your event during the week? Is it on the weekend? Is it in the morning? Is it in the afternoon? A lot of this can determine rates for different venues that you might be looking at. Also seasons. A lot of times some venues are sold out certain months. Some months are wide open, so that might give you a little bit more flexibility. Main objectives of your meeting. What's the purpose of the event? I mean, is it a wedding? Is it educational? Is it convenience? When I talk about convenience, some things that we might be able to do is when we have graduations.
Yeah. I've got a comment about the name. Uh-huh. You might look around what's happening in the community, because when you're out planning an event, the same time that they even say it's going on.
Yes.
And there were no motels in
that. Yes. And that's kind of the thing that we go through is, like, for us, February, March, and April are extremely busy for us. Because of things like the AUSA Missile Conference, or their Global Forces Symposium. We also do the Children's Advocacy event. Then we have volleyball. Then we have the Home Builder Show. So in those few months right there, we have a lot of things just kind of back to back. But depending on what you're wanting to do and what you're trying to get across at this meeting or this event, when I talk about convenience, that's kind of the biggest thing. We do a lot of graduations at the BBC, so a lot of times we'll do a lot of graduation dinners. People are already there for the graduation, you might as well do the dinner there too, then you don't have family trying to travel around town and meet up at restaurants and things like that. If it's a meeting, so education is probably your main point, or if you're hosting a meeting. So you need to think about your audiovisual, different components of that. When you're doing meetings, it's not as important for it to be a ballroom. You know, you're looking for more meeting space and things like that. So your needs kind of change depending on what event you're trying to do. When you get into more entertainment type events, then you're going to be more concerned with your sound, your lighting, production factors, and things like that. And then, of course, celebrations like weddings and things like that, you do tend to think about more decorating, your menu choices and things. Another thing to consider is your venue size. Sometimes we might get a phone call and somebody says, I want to plan an event, and you ask them, well, how many people? What are you looking at? Oh, well, I don't know. So it's kind of hard, and especially a facility of our size, when we have, at this point, we have over 170,000 square feet of flexible meeting space. After our expansion, we'll be over 200,000. But when we can do anything from 35 people to 2,800, we have done some events even larger than that. But I need to kind of know where you're looking at before I can think what's the marks or things like that. So knowing what kind of size you're looking at really kind of helps there. When you're planning an event, is it indoor or outdoor? If you're looking at outdoor events, you've got a lot of rides that want to look at outdoors. So of course you've got to think about weather. When you do outdoor venues, a lot of times you have to rent tables, chairs, you have to bring in lighting, and think about that kind of stuff. And then, as far as working with a budget for an event, it helps a planner if you call and say, hey, this is my budget, this is what I'm looking at doing, because as a meeting planner, we know where we can cut some things, we can add some things to stay within your budget. It's a lot easier to kind of work with that than when we don't know that. But I just wanted to kind of give you guys a few things to think about. certificates of insurance for events. If you have to have an event license, you got to think about taxes, service charges, things like that. If you're doing a conference, then a lot of times you might have sleeping rooms and think about how many sleeping rooms you need and things like that.
Why do you have an event license?
It just really depends on what type of event. A lot of times more of your outside events would require an event license. And depending on the scope of it, like if